the silver ultimate. Go ahead and any good of me versus the post. I also get six. Isn't it? Also, after your magic, or haste.
Yes! あると思う。
倒せない。
battle. Kazuya. Wins. We'll be right back. battle. Kazuya, Banjo, and Kazooie!
Wins.
Start the battle. Ridley. Kazuya.
Thank you.
Kazuya Mishima wins.
Thank you.
battle. Torin. Wolf.
A lot of
Kazuya, Snake! Kazuya.
Wins.
Yeah!
Flowz.
Yeah.
a lot of.
Stop battle. Whoa. King TDD. Whoa.
A lot of
Hello, 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 people. How's it going? Oh my God, we're back. We have stream again. My hair's pulled back. It's a crazy time for all of us. Oh my gosh, but we are back. Were you guys commenting earlier?
No.
This is the first time we're on mic on stream.
This is our first time on commentary today.
First time on commentary. Hi guys, how's it going? If you're joining late or whatever, or watching afterwards, good to see y'all. We're gonna go ahead and just like going straight into it. Honestly, I think they're just about to start. So we got Eki, Ban, Flowz. I agree.
Just make sure recording scores are starting.
Oh yeah, no, we got that. That's fine. And yeah, just here. Where back to fight night, guys.
Back to fight.
This one, I think I know some people are on spring break, but we do miss you. Hopefully, you guys are watching this afterwards to see what's going on. And we're going straight into it. It's going to be Ekidona versus Ban Flowz. Flowz, or however.
Put your sword into Ban. 3,
2, 1, well, did you sword into Ban? Go. Yeah, Ban this guy. I don't even know who this guy is.
That's lame. Yeah, exciting gameplay. Dusting under the lasers.
Honestly, so I do not know what is the bracket for this one. Oh, they're both meta on Winner. Oh yeah, he just scores up. Left the board there. From the hurry over all that. Anyway. Yeah, but still going in. He seems like having a hard time with, like, you know, healing anything.
Yeah, I think, it does really well against characters who want to run in and brawl, because you can kind of just keep them out. But characters like Wolf just have that really oppressive laser that there's not really much stake in. So he kind of has to be the one first to come in.
Yeah, it's tough, it's tough. And right now, like he's still even stocked, so maybe he's getting some percentage back with a lot of his grenades and such. But Ekki's been playing some fire today. I will say she's also, or they've been playing a lot of HDR. She's been a lot of HDR. So, shout out to them. So neck, it's like so. Flowz was able to make the percent back. Actually, here.
Oh, wait.
Loop. The loop always come in handy.
Oh, I feel like kind of eyeing Flowz today. Obviously, I'm in commentary, but there's been a lot of just like sneak into stuff. He's been really good at just kind of like having that off stage, that pressure. I watched him chase Citrus like all the way to the blast zone with it for a kill.
Yo, he's aggressive with it. So he is a bit of a grenade snob, but you know what? It's effective and he's good at it. And I also he does make the random Hail Mary like plays of going all the way off stage. It catches me sometimes. I won't lie. That's my boy. Okay. Ekki right now. I don't remember the last time I seen Ekki play.
I don't know that I've seen it either. They didn't go and kind of all work today.
The egg is generally good with a lot of game.
Yeah. They have a very strong just like fundamental gameplay. And they also do play Paolo, who is very much like the funniest character. I know all of you are gonna yell at me about hair, but at the end of the day I feel like Paolo doesn't really have any gimmicks, so he just understands his moves.
Fundamentals goes down to like game sense,
yeah,
to positioning, very much understanding what like. Oh, it doesn't need to be complicated, but like.
Yeah, exactly. And what's another like very solid and funny character? He doesn't really have any gimmicks. He just kind of has all around stuff, zone.
A very generalist character.
Yeah.
He has a good kill power. There's a lot of if it was like an RPG stat list, you see him a lot of it kill power. Defense is a pretty decent player, and you know, a lot of your beats on random board. Shio for Shio. Shio's on fire as well today. Are we gonna see Shio on stream later? I hope so. Where's my mouse? Is your mouse? Shio 1-3-0.
Oh, it's real close now. Both at kill percent in the last couple seconds.
And like the 3 seconds we looked away to update scores.
He's coming in.
There. Good boy, snaking up to Ekki. I love that.
Oh.
I've never seen many other like snake players, but is it a snake thing or is it a Flowz thing to always just recover up to certain high?
No, that is a snake thing. So snakes have like super armor, so they're able to go high, and they have a lot of good landing options. So you can do a lot of C4 while he's landing, just to try to catch you off guard to the moment that you go back to the ground and just dead you. And you can do that because you can also land down. A lot of damage. And if he gets all the hits, or at least a strong hand, then he'll die. So, it's one of those characters that has a good trial of landing with that character. Not but you know what? Ekidona's like, you could take the foot in the face, and...
We're kind of talking about theory, but... Who was that 190?
Yeah, dude. Ekki is a survivor. Low health hero, because... He was like at the last percent, right? Or he, because he was way in the way.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
But Ekki is like, it goes back to what you're saying. Fundamentals are kind of there, and Ekki knows when to approach and when not to approach. Ekki doesn't like overextending. That's good. Because realistically, overextending is kind of like not the way to play.
And this is a fun play.
It's the way I want to play. Exactly. If I want to get punished for overextending, god damn it, I'm used to it. Instead of for me, like, just sitting here in the corner and just going in and already showing how the fundamentals
didn't have. Oh, yeah, he's just aerial, up air string. Like, 30 seconds in, Snake's already a kill for some.
Oh, okay. Oh, wait, I think Flowz already did that.
Oh!
It's the bear. The bear. The bear.
I was thinking about this, it was either a Samus or a Ridley. It was a screencap that someone posted in the Discord of a wolf bear. And the other character was like literally on the other side of the and it was still a red screen. This move is kind of wild, man.
Oh, what a great nair!
Absolutely.
That was sneaky, too. He got the last hitbox right when he needed it. I like that a lot. Thank you, boy. Man, I'm gonna down throw you, kick you in the face, and then maybe a back air? Oh,
nope. Like he's ready for that one.
Yeah, exactly. You know what? I had that red down. Oh, I thought...
And makes it back.
Yeah, yeah. For a moment, I didn't know if Ekki was going to make it back or not. I thought that was not a
dog. Wolf Uppy is just... It's very deceptive. Wait, what happened?
He still broke. Oh, my God. That's crazy.
Whatever I was just talking about is now irrelevant.
Yeah, all
right. Solid one-stop game.
Yeah, so... Flowz does have the opportunity to make this comeback right here. He is taking a bit of percentages. Hitting a couple of trades though, at 25%, and falling here at 68 though, 76. I think Archie also straight up air, gets a grenade as well. You know what? Archie getting a little tight still in Ekki's favor. Flowz definitely not out of the fight just yet. So, single hit, down air, okay.
Snake is so heavy now. You'd think
the eye of the god.
You'd think a super soldier would go to the gym enough to not survive that.
Back now. Oh, dash attack. This could be it for Luis. And gets it right on point.
Side B. All right.
Got him got out. Aimed in sight. Boom, headshot.
That will do it.
360 no scope included. Actually, no, there wasn't. It was just a straight shot.
Yeah.
I think he curved it a little bit.
It went
not
down
even
just a
360.
Bit.
My man's a false COD player.
It went like out and out and down, I think.
Exactly. That makes it 1-1, though.
Yep. Going on to game 3.
Game 3. Hold up. Let me do something real quick here, guys.
Stop the battle. Snake Wolf.
threes, the three doesn't do anything. There's multiple threes.
There's just multiple threes? There's multiple of you?
Three,
yeah.
Two, one,
I was like, that's, that's not grammatically correct. There's the dragon threes, the pink threes, the king threes, the one, the ace, the Ekidona threes.
Yeah,
Ekidona threes. People call it the Joker, but I call it
true.
Explosions are about to happen. Oh, that was such a great shine all the way up top. Eki has it on download, bro. I think that, like, Eki, like, picked this matchup. Or me. The whole thing. Yeah, crazy, bro. Crazy.
Just gotta play a different character.
I understand that. Some days I just prefer to play, like Pikachu. Some days I'll prefer to play Brawler, some days I want to play. There's multiple characters in this game. Why not have one ball?
Guy, I played in my best of five before this. In a five-game set, I just have mad respect for this. I have my one character. And that's about it.
I think in every Smash game, I only have like and the rest of them. Kind of embarrassing. You know what? Those two characters that I'm good at, guys, damn. Good at. I think both of them are good at. As a person, like, you are very bored of how big he is. And I feel like a lot of common complaints are like, lower than I was before. Dang, I don't play Fox. I don't forward or like, oh, I don't know. What am I ever going to learn? So, eventually, one guy who plays the one character you can never fight. And having the experience of having that is better than
that. In the general level, there's definitely someone who plays everything. That's just nice. But, you know, if you're comes with, like, a lot of, like, smaller scenes, like, here in Tucson, where there's not, there's, like, what, maybe 30 total gold rangers in
the city. Oh, Luis almost looks cool. He also wanted to get up there, but Eki is very patient. They have to say, I don't want to get up there. But Luis is getting these grenades up, having a 50% lead, now 60% lead. 60% some change, actually. Board air? Okay, but Eki doesn't pick this up. Oh, this is barely, this is the back air. Is Eki moving there? No. Luis is now back on stage. This is the grab. Luis is farming for a backer, manages the fifth one, and then the side B Nikita gets 1,000.
There you go.
I got my snow scope.
There really aren't any scopes at all. No, that's not true. There's Snake. I think Snake and Rob are their final two.
Oh yeah, it's just yeah. That was a great, yeah, that down air was actually kind of nutty too. Good stuff there. Game four.
Yeah. So what I was saying was, before we got back into the game, was, I see where you're coming from. Like, there definitely is someone who plays every character, but when in the actual like, competitive scene, especially in like smaller versus like Tucson scene, it's kind of more hard to find. Like, I don't think we even have as many players as there are characters in the roster, so it makes it kind of hard to get like all the matchup knowledge.
Very true. But it's also valuable. Learning to play a lot of different characters means that disadvantage or that said thing. Not many other people play Speed Brawler, but when he shows up, I can. Well, Mark is also just really, really good, but the fact that he plays a character that is very, that was very unknown for a long time, he's Sam is a little more popular, I would say. But the thing about Mark is that he's all the time, right? You get an increased advantage of that, like, how awesome is that? Oh, yeah, I think he's really powerful. I saw the power, and I'm like, yeah, that's epic, right? I think, holy wait, what? Red.
is like an advantage. I'm mostly getting at the aspect of like it's a lot harder to learn a lot of matchups because there's just not every scene has a player.
Well, you know what? At that point, I agree, but at the same time, I will say, what if you would have been fun?
No, I'm not. I feel like we're saying the same thing. You're saying it's like it's good for another character. I'm just saying like, that's why a lot of people.
No, I that's why I'm completely with you. And but you know what, that's the kind of thing I love about all games. I love all of them. I love Ultimate, I love Brawl, you will never catch me hating on any of that. Right? And for me, all of them have and for me, Ultimate is just the rock. It was the thing that was that marketed it. And that kind of like really hyped it up as like a first off of the game like throughout the years, like all, having all the DLC characters come out and expected it to watch it come next is crazy. And I think that this roster, some people are in a good game, but they're just, I don't know, they're just creators. They don't think this roster is good. Everything.
Definitely it's like, because there's just so much to learn. There's a lot of work. It's deep, but not the same way that I guess a lot of all the other fighting games are.
Yeah.
It's not mechanically deep, but it's deep in like there's other things. Like you need to learn a lot more characters that you need to understand your different game plan. Because the game's so simple mechanically, strategy becomes a big thing.
Yeah.
Right? So you really need to work around the way that you play. You will find the character that literally just walls hard. But to get better as a player, rather choose the option of or straight up just like learning what the game is meant to do. You can say that's good for a lot of other games, but I feel like the Ultimate is way more inherent because of the fact that it's
also yeah facts. I just paused. This is actually kind of close.
So there was so Snake's holding a grenade and probably grabs him in back rows. That would have killed except the grenade detonates and hits him up instead. Granted, Eki follows up from the up air for the kill anyway, but just that actual interaction is just, I feel like we needed to at least acknowledge that.
This is very tight, because Beast has the option to, oh my goodness. Okay, got the counter and everything too. Oh, but just barely gets behind Eki. Oh, got it!
Nope.
No, not just yet.
Beautiful DI from
Yeah, a great DI from Ekidona.
Falling.
Oh, no, not dead just yet. Ekidona's still alive. Oh!
Close with that,
super close. Oh, is that gonna be the up air we're gonna see there?
Nope, not quite.
Not just yet. We got a heavy boy on our side. Heavy boy. Oh my goodness.
Going to the
oh my Whoa. Goodness, did it again!
Man. This is not good for my health.
I know. Eki is right here struggling to stay alive. Flowz being very oppressive and very squirrely. Some people call it annoying. It's oh my goodness! Luis takes it!
3-1
for Van Flowz. Good stuff on him.
I don't know.
Good stuff.
Can we ban the man who's going on to Grands?
Yeah,
is that
a thing we can do? That's whack, bro.
Is that something we're allowed to do as TOs?
All right. But ah dang. Let me go ahead and edit this. Yeah. So it's gonna be. Oh my gosh.
Go ahead.
That's gonna be another PR there. That's gonna be another PR win for Flowz for sure. All right. You wanna call that out for me real quick?
Yeah. Grab nothing.
But oh my goodness. Testing. Attention, please. Yeah, we're gonna get Shio and Nothingz here on next.
Alright.
Is it like that? I am going to take an educated guess at this.
Just
a moment. Nothingz, who are you playing? Alright, thanks. I thought so. Activate that.
Perfect.
Nothingz. Oh, Nothingz player one. Quack. Oh my god, is that the mochi? Can we get a quote from the mochi?
Yeah, so the quote is that streets are not that cool. They really aren't.
Yeah. Streets are kind of lame, bro. They're just giant pieces of spaces for car to rock on. That's
I don't
all
know.
They are. Yeah. They're not even good half the time. Yeah.
They're really not.
Dude, I got a flat tire because of roads. I had a flat tire because of roads.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks. Anyways, hold up. Give me a second. Essentially. Wait, get in frame here. Get in. My man. The Messiah. The Mochi. Anyways, we're going to transition back. They're going to go ahead and start. They're going to be starting here in just a sec. But, yeah, Shio is Nothingz. So, kind of, I have not seen much of Nothingz. I think I'm blanking this. I don't know why.
So, Nothingz is a solid player. He kind of popped up last semester. Kind of showed up. Kind of took top 8 in his first turn. This guy. Kind of just, doing that.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
He's definitely newer to the scene. It's interesting. These were both,
Three, two, one.
We're both steep.
Go!
Yeah, at one point, I've known Nothingz for as long as he played Pac-Man, right? So I haven't seen Steve unless he pulled. Maybe I've played one, I'm not sure. But Shio, I've always thought of Pac-Man, so I'm sure. How is that going to be to do? But yeah, it's just interesting to say we can see it.
Oh, that hurts.
Dang, I'm playing too much to get bar. I'm like, oh, I feel like I'm blocked. Like, just steal the life right there, man.
But, yeah, so what happened there was, you know, actually, yeah, it's like down the front to the height. He either made it to drifting in on the wrong bounce, or just accidentally drifted off the ground. Either way,
unfortunately. Oh, that was a perfect angle for either of them. Honestly, Shio's doing really good. This is my first. Oh, you
that's
know what?
The bell for you.
Okay, that's a comedy description right there.
No, it's even.
It's still even.
The SD,
yeah. Well, not even. I said Shio does have a little bit of. Okay, now he still has the lead. Yeah, he's still. Oh, I would have done the same thing. Maybe I would have ran back a little bit more just because I know how much range Titan has, but you know what? It's tough, it's tough. You want to be fast with Ridley, but you have to work a lot of his sluggish. You know what? I want to. Come here. I need you to tell me.
Alright, so the Ridley. Yeah, so he does this, the fireballs. And that's basically his new rule. And then he has some nairs. You can see Shio, really name, he's actually throwing a lot of S matches. Might seem like a crazy option. It's actually a really good option because it doesn't have one end lag, and if he hits one, it's going to kill Pac. I feel like it's okay. It's definitely not a bad match to throw out. You can see a lot of S matches, but they're also fast. Good range. The hydrant in a really good angle, and there's the fireball.
This fireball is a ledge. I don't think Pac-Man has it, some characters that don't really have like as many options for recovery. Really just feel that.
Oh, that's crazy. And is that the raw S smash? We'll take the stock. Yeah, of course.
Messiah, the god, the thing I pray to every time I go to sleep, at least a little bit. So yeah, it's gonna be one.
So kind of a rough one for Nothingz.
Yeah, it was hard.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Ridley got him. We got the spooks, bro. Yeah. Big old dragon guy. I'm telling you, I would be spooked if that Ridley was chasing after you. Would you be scared? I would be a little bit.
Like in real life or in the game?
Both.
In real life, I'd be like, nah.
Not what? You would throw hands with Ridley?
I wouldn't throw hands. I just wouldn't be scared. Like I'm gonna fucking die.
What do you mean? I'm y'all.
Like, why?
At that point, like, then whatever. Are you telling me that are you more scared of him in game than in real life?
In game he's scary. Like, out of game, if I see him coming at me, there's like there's just acceptance. Like there's nothing I can do.
Maybe he'll be at odd. Maybe he'll be at odd. I might also just die in scene 2.
No, actually.
Cyber Dragon Pirate.
Actually, I take it back. Ridley is gonna be like really stupid. So I think I would be scared because he's not gonna give you a quick game.
No, not bro. Evil Dragon guy. Oh my goodness, that was so good.
It was really good, but also really sadistic. Very
yeah, that was
a true Ridley.
Yeah, that was a true Ridley moment right there. Evil bastard. Oh, I thought the super armor definitely would have hit that there. I know that you can hit Ruby, but no. Did it get type B? No. Okay. I like that Nothingz is being very smart about how he's approaching the down smash. You didn't do it that time! Yeah. Oh, but that was cool. Never mind. I've never doubted you. I never doubted you. I'm falling. What do you mean it's not winner's finals? It's loser's semis. No. Hold on. Hold your horses. Hold all the horses. Hold two of the horses. The other one I can hold on for a moment. So hold some of them. Two of them. Three of them. Hold it. And I don't know what you're talking about. It was loser's semis. Okay. I've seen it. Loser's semis finals. And Rose is just being mean. He's trying to gaslight me.
That's a very common Rose thing. No, we're back at the game. Nothingz is down another stock. If you keep doing this, they really, you look away to hit something, and then in that time, someone loses the stock.
I know, man. These players are gamering too hard. They need to calm down.
Why can't like pause the game while we fix them?
Exactly. They need to like make it. Yeah, that Rod is actually good there for Mac. Honestly, the Mac putting in a little work. Oh. I see a win condition on the field. Yeah, yeah, no. I never saw
the game.
I thought I saw something fun. So I think the Mac can make it back. It's super hard. Because the shield just have a grab off stage there. You don't want to be too like angsty. Oh my goodness, just like that. He's gonna get old. Oh yeah, we also have that too. Oh, and he's dead. He's not dead. Takes it back. Perfect stuff. Gets the up tilt. No, he's still in the fight.
He's slowly eating this out. He takes like a solid, couple solid hits. And like, Mac has that throw power. He just struggles.
Oh! Oh!
Raw KO punch from Ledge.
That was actually kind of, that was kind of tight. That was clean.
Hey,
I will say this. Shio had one of the cleanest stocks earlier when he got the grab and the narrative. He's like, get out of here, kid. But then that KO punch kind of did seal the deal there for Nothingz.
Yeah, a little bit.
There you go. Well, damn. Well, I wonder, is Nothingz going to throw us another character now? It was a bit close, so maybe, I don't think, maybe he still has the confidence in Mac. He still has the... Okay, great.
The thing with KO Punch, aside from it just being like absurdly strong, is it just has that you have to like play against him in an entire game.
Exactly.
Like if you whip a single move, you could just die.
Yeah, no, for sure. And honestly, KO Punch, now I think KO Punch only kills at around like 30 or so. I don't know the exact numbers, but it doesn't kill at 2-0. I know that much.
Yeah.
But it kills extremely early.
I think it's like 30.
If I had to, maybe against Ridley, it's around 30. I would say for Ridley would be around 30.
That kill.
That kill.
Even with the kill spark, I did not think it was killing.
You know what? I almost want to say that up B for Little Mac is, you know? it's not a good recovery. It's a good air.
Yeah. Pretty good attack.
It puts you in the free fall still, so maybe get it again!
Ooh, good old down tilt to neutral. Nothingz. Down tilt to KO punch.
Yeah, Nothingz is playing this game like a genius right now.
Yeah.
A little, or maybe like a little bit. Never mind, like a genius.
Also, I feel like there's a lot of questioning why you would take Mac of all characters to FD. Let's the last place I would want to play against Little Mac.
Maybe I would assume maybe because you don't have your opponent doesn't have the options to run away. No, they're always gonna be grounded. But even so, you can catch them on landing. That's what I think that's the best at.
Right? No, I'm saying, why would you go to F?
Oh, see, yeah. Oh, wait. Three, two, I think
one,
we have to pause. I think we have this character ban.
I don't believe we have it.
No, not yet.
We have not made an announcement on that.
We have not made it.
They're legal for today.
Alrighty. Just want to make sure. I think
we do need to do something.
We've announced it for Rise.
That's a very good question. I think we're still...
Honestly, well, in the night case, we're gonna see if any cheese comes out. Honestly, the Little Max and I have a real hard time here. Unless the punch... No, it still has it. That would put the people...
Those don't really get on the stand. These bots are gonna be... real hard, yeah, just kind of have to force you to wait it out and really chase him.
Yeah, no, he's playing very patient. Hit him with the god.
So what we've learned today is that Max boxing gloves can protect you from the ball. So I should probably invest in some of those.
Honestly, same. I think it would be kind of a to actually, like, eat up lava monsters with.
Yeah. Just common occurrence.
This became cheese.
Yeah.
This became comedic. Oh, Shio. Playing the matchup right. He's playing it all so wrong. Because he is down a stock. And honestly, the Mac might be able to break through like that. Ooh. With a double side B. No. He's still alive.
I never give Max Psyche the credit it deserves. It's kind of just like a really good Hell Mary.
That's there.
True.
There we go. That one didn't hurt the ball.
That's it. Side beat down. Back out of it.
Now back. Oh, okay, perfect. Guess the upward version is to be able to hit him when he goes high.
I think the issue with Psyche is you can only use it once before you go.
What is... Oh, wow! That was so clean. Did you see what he did?
Yeah.
He went off. Side B. Is my man
raw forward smash?
My man cracked that forward smash. If the Little Mac wins, that's actually kind of hype. No.
Little Mac is gaming right now.
Yeah,
that's
man.
All I'm saying.
It's the Steve counter, bro.
True.
It's the Steve counter.
You know, I'm going to make my own Steve matchup chart here in a bit. Okay, ready?
He's chilling.
Obvious win. Obvious losing for Steve.
Little Mac. Off the bat.
Obvious win for Steve. Everyone else. Done.
Little Mac. Holy man. The dash attackers. The thing is that nothing he does a good job.
He's
scouting
his legs.
Like... Oh, okay, he's dead. So it is 64%. It is Little Mac. Little Mac can cheese. Geo can be able to take this in 5. That grab was absolutely comedy. Oh, and but Little Mac is coming in, and I love that he's constantly throwing out the
back. Whoa,
the
forward smash! And that's
there you
game
go.
4, 3-1 for Nothingz.
Good. Just running in and out of Steve's attack. Still just really having trouble getting any of his momentum going. It was great. Nothingz really showed that up, because you know what? Maybe the Pac-Man failed him, but you know what doesn't fail him? The Little Mac. All right. Then going on next, we're gonna have Ekidona and Nothingz, right? But yeah, we'll give you a bit. Besides, there's stuff to talk about. There's stuff to break down of what happened. Okay.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. So like, look, I think that game one with when Nothingz did take it, and oh, not Nothingz, when Shio did take it against the Pac-Man, he was playing really well. No, because also he was playing Ridley too.
Yeah, no, there was also the fact that Nothingz did mess up lose his recovery 2 stocks
exactly.
In that game. So 2
SDs. Yeah, I forgot about that. Man.
So actually more credit to Nothingz.
Honestly,
from
true.
A 2 SD game 1 to reverse 3-0-ing.
That shows that you have a lot of integrity just to not get bricked. You know? You have the resolve to keep going on.
Like, you have to respect that, just like that mental fortitude.
Exactly.
Like,
exactly.
I don't know if I SD'd twice in my first game. I would not have taken it back from a 3-1.
Man, if I SD, that's like a normal bracket for me. I SD all the time. Man.
I feel that.
It's tough, okay? Sometimes you play characters and you realize, man, I want to get back to stage. You mess up one little input when you're off stage. That's why when you see a lot of new Smash players come in, they get so nervous when they're off stage. Mm-hmm. They get so nervous. And you know what? Everyone still kind of has it just a little bit today. But
to this day, I think the hardest thing to learn in this game is recovery.
It is. It is very difficult.
Neutral is very intricate and disadvantage, but like when you're picking up the game and just learning to move, learning to press buttons,
what time is it?
That recovery down is an issue. It is 8:30 or 8:20 actually.
All right, we might not do a bracket tonight for that. Then we're just gonna keep it to friendlies for that over there.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Yeah, we'll just keep it to friendlies.
That thing.
Yep. But we'll be back. We're giving the players a little bit of time to break, and we'll be back here in just a second with more Ultimate.
See you soon.
I'll see you sexy people later. Hey, we're back.
Yo.
Yo, yo. I have a... Okay, sandwich. Good. It's actually made with blueberry muffin bagels. But
I'm not a PB&J guy, but you know what I am? I am a blueberry bagel guy.
Bless me. Anyway, let's get into it, okay? Let's get into it. Guys, these guys know.
We're getting set up.
And my eye contact's me, they'll know.
Little man!
Definitely in. Just in terms of, like, history. Definitely an uphill battle for
Nothingz. Oh,
and
he
decided
to go...
3, 2, 1,
they are now
go!
No, that's really good. Dang, okay, well, Eki got, it's like, okay, I see some losers right now, but it's time to get up a bit. Going in, you're saying two, the power, it's like,
massive damage right off the bat, 30 seconds in, and Mac is at 130, but Nothingz, again, keeping that patience, running back and forth, waiting for,
oh, I thought that was a good crack. Oh, that's it.
He'd be a real puffer, wouldn't he?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I don't know.
But Nothingz is really good. Yeah, what a bat. And a couple of those. And at least three of them. It's Steve and Ridley. It was a bit, run around a little more, but I can't. How is just, like, aerial superiority hurts a lot more for Matt? Because, like, in disadvantage here, there's just not really much Matt can do. Like, he's not gonna... Oh,
that was good. I'll give Nothingz credit for one.
Perfect. He's really good at just these whiff punishes. These hard punishes.
You don't have to get good at that as Matt, because, yeah, like, you need to be real creative. You know, and honestly, even though... over here at 25% chilling in the film, I honestly think that Nothingz might be able to make a, like, crazy, like, forward smash read or, like, up B kill Eki really early or something. You have to beware of the cheese, you know? And, yeah, but Eki makes it really clean with that. Oh.
There.
I wish I was in this game. Oh. There you go. No, that's great.
So you're
no, that's great. Someone's gonna like it.
That's an improvement.
Too bad for you.
Nothingz definitely putting in the work, though, I think. Honestly, it's such a tough matchup. Also, I'm very quiet.
Start the battle! Little Mac Omotena!
We're right back in the same matchup, same stage. Was it PS2 again?
So it's a run back?
I think it was. It PS2? I didn't quite catch it.
I believe it was PS2.
Three,
it was not PS2.
Two, one,
okay. It's PS2.
Go!
PS2 is a platform, but it's a battle. Where all the stuff happens.
The classic.
That parry is so big for extra. Now it's an advantage. Whatever's an advantage. Oh?
Nothingz really is the only matchup where I know he will take this battle.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
He's also big.
I love that. Even everyone knows that Mac is dead there, but I love that Mac player is still going for it. What if, like, Eki decides to, like, hit him and kill? Gets, like, the weak kid. That's great. Oh, but this doesn't happen. This is not at all.
Ooh. Super. One way to make it back.
Mac is land. Mac's great. Options are awesome.
Calling out the air dodge.
His timing is crazy. Sometimes Nothingz get these ridiculous plays that give him so much benefit if that's so unfortunate.
I mean, a pretty good drift out from a Eki. He knows what's coming.
A B? Oh my goodness. Nothingz is making sure. Nothingz
is playing like a magic.
Eki's doing so well, though. Eki's doing so well doing what Kali does best, is just comboing back in the air. Don't sleep. Oh! Everyone.
Yeah, God, get hard punished for that one. I think he's dead. Yeah.
Nope. No, he's alive!
Back. Well, he made it back, so it was back. But
he ain't no chump. He made it back.
He did kind of just immediately hit and get up.
Up! No!
He's not gonna fall for that at this time.
Yeah.
Extra Road Fresh was really good at just like. I think parts of them was really good at just hitting the down. When they're playing patient, when they're playing top of their game, they will catch on to everything they're doing and not just get away with it.
The download will happen for sure. And Eki looks like they have the download pretty secure right now, but Nothingz is still throwing hands. Oh, that's it.
No, he had his jump. Oh, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It doesn't really. All right, that's going to be game two going from the mech. Oh, well, no, it wasn't a reverse 3-0.
Well, it was from a one game down. But
yeah,
still.
It was one game down.
Drop
but you know what? When
3-0.
He's two games down, he's going to win the whole tournament now.
Yeah. Easy.
He had to multiply it. Now he's down two games. He's going to win the next
to win nine games.
Yeah. Easy. He needs to go on the craziest win streak ever. Honestly, my boy Nothingz, I believe.
Just taking it through with him. Gotta respect him.
I just love his style. His style's pretty good. And I love, I like both these players. I think Eki, I've always compared Eki to being like, dang, you do everything right every time. You know? It kind of has to, Nothingz doesn't have it, but it's like the football ball approach, where he just does the craziest stuff that always catches you off guard and catches you enough to play. That's it. That's it, baby. He has the Ethan effect where he was straight up.
Oh, red is again.
Oh my god.
How many times have we seen that today? Too many, man. Too many. And I don't get tired of it.
Oh, but Ekidona, what a great board smash, though. That was also really good. I like that they're just bopping each other. Like I said, Eki will choose the right option a lot of the time, and I think it's what's been winning her these games so far. But
Eki's just catching on to the fact that Nothingz just kind of really wants to commit to these uppies, and Eki's just not having it, getting hard punishes out of it.
Okay.
Not gonna kill.
So, it's on deck. Nah, it's gone. Like that Ekidona throughout the board smash. Know when the wind box might come in clutch, you know? Oh, that should be the kill.
Good stuff.
Yeah. Is that a kill?
No, not killing.
Yeah, but it's a good amount of damage. Now, the next one that does happen, or, you know, a good solid forward smash, I'll be able to take it. Okay, great. He put in armor up the
Okay.
41%.
I see the dream.
Yeah, the dream can definitely happen, but it looks like Ekidona is. Oh, off stage, just not. Edgar back throw. This is looking like it's going to end. Dashed attack. Oh, but this.
Hold on to it and get some damage out. There it goes. I have to say something.
Drag down.
Joked. You good?
I'm chilling. I cannot believe that. I think Eki got straight up battlefield.
Yeah.
You know? That was unfortunate. That was unfortunate.
I think Nothingz really was just kind of applying some heavy pressure there.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it just kind of got to
it. Got that little bit
of a miss.
It's happening.
I see the dream.
Yeah.
Oh my god. I cannot believe it. I thought it was not real, but one, I love that Nothingz. Go! You know, I'm starting to see why Nothingz keeps getting people to battle him back. He wants that, like, upbeat off the top platform. I believe that move is more powerful when you take it from the ground than you take it from the air.
Yes, it does. It has that property where if you take it from, like, if you're on the ground or knockback, it, and that's not very much like true. But he moves really well. He has a lead. Now he can lose the lead just as easily. He's gonna, oh, he got greedy! He got greedy. Down smash coming there from Ekidona. And yeah, he does not want to. That's the thing about Little Max. Oh, punch. Oh,
there was a fastball to dodge the side B, and that kind of just.
Oh wow! What a wrong great option. Yes, things are evened up still, and you know nothing's still in this fight.
I said it last time, but I really constantly underestimating how good that side B really is. It's kind of, it does everything Max wants to do. Well, almost, except that he can only use it once. Aside from that.
Oh, that was a zero to death there from Ekidona. Yeah. Great zero to death.
Eki is not taking prisoners today, man. After.
No. He took that last one
hard. And he, like, knocked.
God, the Little Mac cheese. That's okay. Oh, my goodness. Still alive. I sense a down attack.
But the shield is like a little kick attack.
Yeah. Oh, is that gonna be? No. He still has the punch. There you go. Okay. It is not over yet. I think we called it too early last time. We will definitely not do it this time. It can be anyone's game. Nothing is down. Oh! I don't know if that can
fair to kick it.
Boom.
3-1 for Ekidona.
One to Ekidona.
Too bad for you.
The finals were, they're going to meet Flowz again. Try to get that run back. Oh, will we see the wolf? I don't know. But, and put in... Wait, don't start until I tell you.
Just hit update, we're fine. We're set.
3, 2, 1, go!
I'm going straight into it, though. But... Oh yeah, inner side. It's crazy. Oh dang, at 13%?
There it is again, where we stop to edit something. And in that second, someone just gets exploded.
Just stop, edit, and just pop it back. Eki's going ham. Look how Eki is. And all this percentage that he's doing himself and being in the last zone is definitely not helping him. The counter was such a good, it lasted so long. Oh, it's on him now. He has to be careful. Timer is coming up soon. Where is he?
I think he's going to go up.
Now, he's slow. He's taking his back. He's only at 78% with him. Now back to zero on his last thought. The jab. Now, Roman, he's been put into his favor. He might be able to get his bag. But it's going to be a definite enough to battle. He has to have a lot of action. Yeah.
Oh,
that's
a
good one. Try to go with the Kamaha. That's where Herman is staying there. Oh! This is a great try. process back here.
You're trying to make it back. I love the use of orbital there.
The double back, double spot dodge. That was some American spot dodge stuff. It wasn't to ledge, but you know, it's just spot dodging instantly.
The board smash.
Yeah.
But Palu has that tool that can fight.
No,
stay
high from the light.
Yeah. Get away from my ledge.
Exactly.
I'm going to recover, and you're going to take however much percent.
Oh, I always forget that.
Low,
there you go.
Update.
My bad.
You can't read, it's okay.
Yeah, you can also get enter.
Ah, I did not know that.
Yeah. So if I want to give him a time for someone, then I'll take it away.
3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, we're here in game two. You know what I love? So me and some other players were talking about this. I think it's amazing. It's a thought where giving it straight count for the run back, like even if you lock the stage, sometimes you can counter the choice. And if you can show your opponent how to do it to win on that stage, then it can do wonders to their mental, like drain. Get the run back, show them handsome on that stage, now they're stuck on the board. You know? Now, in that case, like, they could go to a but it's good to show that you have confidence in your character. Oh, but you know, there's no confidence coming from me. When I saw something like that, that was a straight up great down air there.
Okay. Just kind of hanging out off the wood and close to a panic air dodge, and then Ekidona being ready for that with the full on
down air. The block.
Down air.
Yeah, but I gotta give full credit there. He's close. He was able to catch Ekidona's jump just there. The Fifi, roll up to. So good. Ekki gives me a good stream, the double dash attack. And they're rooting against my boy Flowz. They don't want to see a snake succeed, bro. Not in this economy. Back on Ekidona. Now
I have no idea.
It's back on Flowz now. It becomes a whole game, bro. It was exploded.
I think it's gone.
So it is.
Oh no, yeah, it's still on the ground.
Now. Oh, catches the jump. Ekidona is in the lead right now. Oh, misses the nair. Back throw. Flowz. Oh!
Calls it out.
Yeah. And he's doing so well by calling out bad habits of Flowz. Dash attack though. He's able to get that good burst option. Instead of neutral, even getting some straight hits in there. Back air. Now Ekidona's disadvantage. Oh, is that gonna be a down throw back air? Oh, it misses!
It's the reversal forward tilt. Now that side gets out, we just know that. Yeah. How would the teleport kind of ignore that? Where yeah. When Ekidona's playing more player, that would be hard.
I love that he's backed away. He knew that he felt like Ekidona was given too much time to deal with projectiles and, you know, probably would have reflected or something. So he respected that, backed away a little bit. He did not want to get hit by some projectiles, especially if you're trying to make him succeed right there. Ekidona is doing such a well job. Also, just taking time away. Taking time to really get in on those projectiles can definitely help him.
I will say, Flowz just have that 1.4
there. Oh, yeah, the 1.4 lead.
But the 1.4, I
think. It's a big one. Yeah. One that I would be honestly worried about.
Listen, all I'm saying is I was 1.4, I have 1.4 disadvantage. So why would you play the game? But
you know what? Luis is making it pretty winnable right now.
Yeah.
And honestly, he's down like 50 or 19, way more now. Ekki's doing well.
40%. Ekki is really just like slowly interacting.
Yeah, and Flowz's shield is not making it. Whoa, that grab. Oh, Now the back throw. This looks like this might be.
Oh yeah, there's the other. Ekidona taking game two.
Ekidona definitely taking a game two.
It was a close match. I really think we might.
Oh, man, it's tough to say. What?
I have no idea how this works.
Oh, there is two. Lamps. That one.
Close the wrong one.
No, I didn't. Oh, that's why. Okay.
Stop the battle. Yeah, that. Snake Omotena.
That's why. Awesome, awesome. Oh, so this is direct. This is direct. Okay, thanks. I didn't know that. Okay, chill. Well, then going in, that's on the back, going to game three here. So, Flowz was making a great showing that last game, but taking it to last stop. Even so, we just want that. What we're looking for is that magic that he got from that one game in the last set. Because Ekidona is now showing up her full strength. He gets the main character out. Everything and is performing really well. But it's going to be up to Flowz to be able to recreate that magic earlier, or just even try to pull back over Ekidona to get some momentum back to get that happening.
Victory and Eki is already definitely up to a solid 100%.
I guess 90. Well, now 100. Now 100. Now, literally 100.
Well, off by 3, but,
well, now he's dead, okay? Now it's down to stop.
Math is no longer relevant.
Math is no longer relevant. Math is I used to be on the forum, but you know, right now it's just considerably tough. Making the comeback on, or making the getting back the lead again, Alina is... I don't know how Smooth does against this matchup. But, oh, get time. What are you doing? Move yourself up. Oh, I wonder. No, yeah, this is really unfortunate. Right now, Flowz is having such a hard time.
Can we talk about the windbox just launching the grenade onto the side?
Yeah, no, I saw that too. Dude, wind boxes in this game are kind of crazy. They have some weird physics too. Okay.
I'm gonna kill it, but...
Oh, that's so unfortunate. You know what? Does... It was aiming it perfectly. He was trying to get Nikita. He went to all the right locations. But Ekidona, like, Ekidona is the 5D dodgeball. You know how to get around here.
Let's finally secure a stock with that up smash there.
Up smash. You know what? The up smash is more of a machine tool and as far as I can tell.
Yeah, I can see that. It's definitely
just
like,
it's just like they're like, don't jump. I don't want you to jump.
I talked to Flowz a little while ago, just talking about like, his general, like, when he's throwing out projectiles, what his general plan is. It just, that's what I want to do without the thing. It's mostly just to hit, don't go this way. And if they hit, that's great, I get damage. But they're mostly just there to control where you're going to go as this might be at home.
Oh, he could have spot dodged that. I think he thought it was going to be a forward tilt. Oh, he killed that. What a great tag. What a better tag. That's gonna be the reset.
All right, we got the reset.
No, hide
from the light. I want to leave it up there for a couple seconds. One, two, three. All right, now Flowz. A clean 3-0 there from Eki. Now evening things up. It's gonna be one more set, and that's gonna be it. Who wins?
It's
a short fight and all that. Like, it's
all
we're already at with the grands.
Yeah, man. It's specifically because Eki got sent to losers, and now it's gonna be weird. So, once again, Flowz is not out of the game yet. They're both in losers. He does need just to win this one set and see this Ekidona. So, yeah, hold on to your butts. This is gonna be a good one. I think Flowz might take a moment. Really, like, what's the battle last match? The exact same thing, apparently. You know?
Sometimes you gotta stick with it.
It's kinda, you know, at first when you don't succeed,
everyone underestimates the no mix up. He's too good.
Double up smash?
When up smash 1 doesn't work, up smash 2. The bridge can punch the same thing.
They can't punch
the same. They don't read you doing the same thing. There's no way.
What are the chances of
it? Exact same thing. If I do it a second time, there's no way I'm going to do it a third time. So I'll do it a third time.
Exactly. And that's how you play the game. You just need to get stuff over and over again.
Yeah.
Because you need to psych your move.
Just pick
a kill.
You just stick to it.
Yeah.
Just forget that you always yell at it. That's not right.
For aggregate upping, for Flowz, is SD. And everyone has their
own thing. Everyone has just getting hard on this one. It's
if I do it again, maybe I'll be. Oh, no. I thought the was a lot lower. I thought the upper was down. I was still there. More blue. All this stuff. Real hard. Ooh, almost missing the down smash. I think he was a little off. Or maybe I think Eki might have angled it or just got the just really not hit by it. It was just oh. Oh, shenanigans. That I will say that a lot of
shenanigans.
There's a lot of weird moments. Honestly, you should just mention every single time you're on the spot. It's not. This might be a JD.
It doesn't work when we try to.
JD's happening. I almost. I feel it. I feel it in my rattle nose. Oh my goodness. I thought the grenade got up to the shirt.
Oh, bruh.
Bruh. the random grenade. Nice.
Armor is really good.
There you go, back. Oh, he's still alive! The GI of the guard.
I said before, mistake is still alive.
Game one going to Ekidona.
Alright, that's
too bad for you.
Are we gonna see the 6-0?
That would be a shot to the heart.
Yeah.
And Eki wasn't too late. He gave Flowz.
Stop the battle!
Snake. Exactly. Watch it later. Oh, back. Dun dun dun.
I throw my.
Go!
Definitely with more.
Hey, when you're making parody, sometimes it has to be more fun.
Like, this man, I'm a dance major, not a music major. Someone else makes the songs that I'm trying to
make. I'm a copyright that song, honestly.
Hey, now, I put more lines, but I get the fuck, right?
I'll give you royalties if I make money off of it. What?
You heard me.
You know what? You can't keep me happy. That.
I didn't say that. I just said speaking of copyright.
One. I want more.
Friends, you should lift the pump. I'm just saying you can't tap it. You have to do it all.
60%? I think you can deal with some damage to the
movie.
I thought for sure,
as long as my
that option. Just hitting the button. I honestly thought he was going to do the C4. And I actually took a second on that. Flowz is stick C4 on Eggie's stun. But Eggie doesn't care. He still goes fully aggressive. Flowz just can't find the time to get Ekidona in the air and get him set up.
Yeah,
oh my goodness.
I think one of Flowz's big strengths is just...
Too bad for you.
Fighting the pressure that comes with that comes to his advantage. Eki just isn't allowing that to happen.
Yeah. Yeah. Eki's advantage state is really solid.
Yeah.
Very strong.
Stop battle. Mark of Athena.
Oh, man. I thought for a moment, I was like, oh, dang. The Mars?
The Flars?
The Flars? The Flows? The Flows? The Flows?
The Flows?
Wait, you know what? Just realize. Sorry about that, guys. Some people might have been confused out there, but he's just close.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, thanks. Oh, up to the through. Toes back, he's back to the speed game. You know what? It always in the beginning, I feel like he set his best. Right, where I just can't get something on slow. And he has a good combo, he has good screens, he has good leads. But then he starts to lead. And always ends up a lot weaker than he started. Oh.
And that is another thing that I mentioned earlier. Really good speed of those down modes, which is why I think we're starting to move into very hard in their favor. Oh, Flowz is definitely down. I can't say he's playing, but I think Ekki is just staying very much.
I think Flowz is, I don't know, man. I think Flowz is still the same. For the last couple of years recently, and I haven't seen him mix it up a lot. Still there, no, that was taken. Where I but at the same time, I don't think it's perfect. I do think it's why Flowz is better. The thing is that I think now the one that really gets in favor that we're just not. Or against
him. Yeah.
Eggie has all this chill as a beam right now. Up to the game, back to Pokemon Stadium. Already has the set. Yeah, not the reset. The momentum is very much in his face. All great. Air dodge there. This is my I love that Eki was patient about it. He wanted to wait. Oh!
I think just the edge of the board.
Yeah, I think it was just the tiny edge. It's because all of it is just one hitbox, man.
Yeah.
It has Eagle no weak part of it, and it has a wind box. It's a good board time. I like the Eki. I think it's not the best. I think that Palu is much better. But it's. Man, it has the song. The double dash to the back air with two basically moves you can't contest about. He's gonna do it again. Hit him with the dash. Oh, if he's hard. Oh my goodness, that's gonna be game.
Again, with just the edge of that board.
Oh my goodness, just the edge too, and that's gonna be it. Ekidona is gonna be your winner. Yay! Well, there you go, guys. It's honestly, that's going to be it for Fight Night this week. Ekidona wins, you know?
Second Hunt. Place to Flowz, third place to Nothingz.
Indeed, indeed. And yeah, honestly.
Eki coming back from a pretty rough grand finals.
Yeah.
Or not grand, from a pretty rough winners finals. And just coming back and then just 6-0-ing Flowz.
Yeah. Like, Eki got pissed. Eki's like, nah.
Back with a vengeance.
I'm a try a little bit right now. I'm just gonna,
know, trying to get some sauce in. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it. We're going to call it there. You guys make sure to take it easy. Remember, losers never win.